Good evening, guys. So today we are going to see some of the functions, some of the features, how it's going to work. So basically, I prepared for you one PowerPoint presentation here. Let's go and see that. So far we have done these labs, guys. It's feeling bore for everybody. So I'm going to show you that. Okay. Show IP DHCP. Show IP telephony service, show version, show inventory. And the first command today I'm going to show you that show voice port summary, guys. Let's see that. What is that exactly? So just connect it to our voice gateway. Admin Cisco. Yeah. Show voice port summary. If you see here, I just want to show you something very, very important, guys. Right now in my voice gateway, okay, if you see here in my voice gateway, I have a FXSO ports are there. Like FXSO is nothing but foreign exchange office. So basically this FXO card, it has right now we can call it as a 4 FXO. Sometimes you will find 2 FXO, which means there is a FXO card will be available, guys. That card you need to purchase whenever you need to have analog lines. So basically we have a 2 type of lines which you are going to receive from your service provider. The first one is analog line and second one is digital line. So here just we discussed about the analog line. So analog line is nothing but, for example, someone has told you that 4 FXO, which means let's open the Google now to understand very clear. Let's see here, 4 FXO card. You see here, images. There you will find, click on this guy. Are you able to see this one? If you see here, we have a 4 FXO card, guys. So here the 4 FXO is nothing but, it has port number 0, port number 1, port number 2 and port number 3, which means at a time you can able to connect 4 analog lines. So these 4 analog lines you can able to connect it to the service provider. So that is called PSTN. So by default in 2911 router you can able to connect up to 4 cards. Like this cards you can able to connect it, 4 cards. So this is the analog card. And this analog card, it's going to support up to 4 analog lines. And again, sometimes you will find 2 FXO, which means it's going to have a 2 analog ports and it's going to support 2 analog lines. So for example, if you see here somewhere, I can able to show you, I believe this is, I can show you this. Yeah, if you see here, this is your PRI, I believe. Okay. This is also 4 FXO. Let's go and type it now. No need to worry about that one, guys. Just type here 2 FXO. So if you see here, there is a card. It supports 2 analog lines. So if you see here, there is line 1 and line 2. So you can purchase with Cisco whenever you are going to place the order for your voice gateway. You can tell them that I want a voice gateway with 2 analog lines. I want a voice gateway with 4. For example, let's say that total I have a 6 analog lines. That time what I am going to do, I am going to buy 2 FXO cards. So first of all, I need to buy 2 FXO card. One is 4 FXO, other one is 2 FXO. So that if you combine these two, it will be 6. So at a time it's going to be support 6 analog lines. So if you see at the back side of your voice gateway, let's show you that picture as well. so that it will be more clear for you guys. If you see here, for the back side, Cisco 2911 router. Let's go and see here. Click on this guy. This is actually 2911 router, guys. If you see at the back side of this router, I can show you there is one card. You can put it one card here, second, third, and fourth. That it's going to support up to four line cards. You can able to connect it here. Okay, and each card, let's say that here I can connect four FXO one card, and here I can connect two FXO again. If you want, I can connect four FXO again. If you want again, I can connect four FXO again. So it's up to you guys. So basically what I'm trying to tell you, FXO is nothing but foreign exchange office, which is going to use to connect your analog lines. So right now, if you want to know how many ports in my router, in my voice gateway, through command line you want to see. For example, physically if I see my gateway, I can able to see that, okay, it has four FXO card. Okay. But if you want to see through the command line, then what you can do now, simply you need to go to router with the console mode or through telnet, and you can able to see that. See here, right now it's saying that, it's showing that FXO, FXO something, right guys? Let's see here. I just want to make it highlight for you so that you guys are very clear. FXO card one, FXO port 1, FXO port 2, FXO port 3, and FXO port 4. Okay guys, so it has four ports. It's a single card, it contains four ports. And again, what about this F001, F002? Did you see here? Because actually we created how many DNs, guys? We created total four DNs. If you observe there, you created four DNs. That's why it's showing that this is two channels, guys. I'm sorry. This is two channels. F50. By default, whenever you create a channel, usually what you are going to do, you are going to say ephone -dn one, then you are going to say dual line. So here the dual line is nothing but you are going to create two channels. You are going to create two channels. That's why what it's doing, for every DN, how many channels you are going to create, those many virtual ports are going to create. That virtual ports always start with 50 0 by 0, either 1 50 0 by 0 1, which means this is for first DN. And again, if you see the 2, that is for second DN. The 3 and 4, you can able to see this one, guys. Are you clear? So, and I just want to show you one more thing, very interesting stuff. If you want to see what are the DNs we configured, you know that show run section ephone -dn. That's it. You can able to see the DNs here. Let's see here. I have a DN1, DN2, and DN3, and DN4. I can able to see that. If you see here, DN1, DN2, DN3, and DN4. And if you see here, for the first DN, what I told you, it's a dual line, which means I created two channels. So the channel numbers will be 50/0/0, 50/0/0/1, the channel 1. And 50/0/0/1. Okay, it's a single DN and it has two channels, here 1 and 2. So these two channels are allocated to that. And same way we said that dual line, this is for DN2. Now my question is that, let's say that I created this time, let's say that ephone -dn, let's say that 10. Then after that you can say dual line. Then immediately you can able to see there is two DNs, I mean two channels has created. Now I'm going to say number 2010, name you can say that Usha, label you can say that Usha. Then after that, what you can see here, do show voice port summary, so that you can able to see the DNs along with your, you know, you can see the channels, the virtual ports along with your DN. This is what I'm trying to show you. So that's why whenever you see here, for example, DN number 10, how many channels it has? You can able to see 1 and 2. And same thing, if you see here, DN number 1, it has two channels, 1 and 2. And DN number 2, it has two channels. DN number 3, it has two channels. DN number 4, it has two channels. This is what I am trying to explain to you guys. That is very important command, very interesting to understand. And again, I just want to show you one more interesting stuff. that is called do show voice dial peer summary. So whenever you type show dial peer, I think without hyphen, guys. When you show dial peer voice summary, I'm sorry for that. Do show dial peer voice summary. I'm sorry for that. So if you type here, very interesting, guys. After you created the DNs, make sure that for every DN, it's going to create, it's the moment how you, what you are doing here, usually you are saying that ephone iphone DN number one, then after that you are saying that dual line, so how many lines you wanted, then after that you are saying that number 2001, then after that you are saying that name Seshu, then after that you are saying that label Seshu. Now if you see here 2001, which is my DN1, if you see here, are you able to see this one? And again 2001, and here it's created a tag. Did you observe it here? So these are the dial peers, guys. Automatically these are the dial peers which is going to create. The moment when you create the DN, automatically it's going to create the dial peers. So these dial peers, we didn't create it, it creates automatically. So what I am trying to do, tell you that dial peer is nothing but call legs. Okay, people, they used to call as call legs. So the legs is nothing but if you want to make friend or if you want to make a call to anyone in your network, you require a call legs. So based on this call legs only, you can able to call each other. That's what I'm trying to explain to you guys. So that's why whenever you type do show dial peer voice summary, you can able to see the default dial peers which you created in the DNs. Automatically it's going to show you. Usually these, basically the dial peers, you can able to see incoming dial peers and outgoing dial peers. There is two type of dial peers are there basically. The first one is incoming and second one is outgoing. So incoming is nothing but the dial peer, whenever somebody is calling to you, that dial peers we can, because your voice gateway is going to receive that call and it's going to send it to you the respective the device. Let's say that I connected to the switch and I connected a couple of IP phones. So what is happening here? The first action is 2001 and second action is 2002. So for example, when somebody call from outside, the call is going to come to my voice gateway. Then my voice gateway, it just based on my configuration, it will say that go this call to 2001. So it's required some incoming dial peer to process your call. And outgoing dial peer means, for example, I am here sitting here in my office. If I want to make a calls to outside of the people, let's say that I am in Dubai, guys. So in Dubai, I just want to call some of the people who is sitting in Sharjah. So the call will go to my voice gateway from my phone and it will process it and it will send it to outside. So that's why your voice gateway, what it will do, it's going to connect it with the PSTN, and the voice gateway it's connecting to the switch. From the switch, what we are going to do, we are going to connect a couple of IP phones. So basically your voice gateway, what it will do, it's going to do the call processing. That's what I'm going to tell you guys. Either incoming or outgoing. Incoming means the call which is coming from outside to inside. That is called incoming. Outgoing is nothing but from your inside, it's going to outside. So that is, we can call it as a outgoing. So this is, you can call it as a incoming. So that's why to attend these calls, we require a dial peers, incoming dial peers, outgoing dial peers. Actually, these dial peers, we can call it as a default dial peers, which is going to create the moment when you create the DN, automatically it's going to create the dial peer for each and every DN. That's why you can able to see here 2001, 2002, 2003, 2004 and 2010. These are the DNs which I created in my phones, because the DN is nothing but extension number. For example, what I have done, for my reception, I want to use 2001. So whenever you create the DN, how you are going to create the DN? You are going to say ephone-dn. Then you are going to give the DN number. Let's say this is 1. Then after that, you need to tell either dual line or you want to say octoline. Means For example, I told you that number 2001. So for this extension, I have created two lines, which means if somebody calls, so the first means how many channels I created here. That's what my meaning, guys. If you see my previous video, you can able to understand. Whenever you say the dual line means you are creating two channels for one DN. So the first, when the call comes to you, automatically it's going to receive your channel number one. In case if other people are calling to the same DN, automatically the call will place it in the second channel number two. In case the user, what he can do, he can able to see that somebody is calling me. See, for example, I'm going to show you this lab practically, guys. For example, if you see here, this is my IP phone. So my extension is 2001. So right now I am going to call from 2002. Let's say 2002. See here, I'm sorry, I need to call 2001. See, the call is coming from Malaysia. So I am going to answer this call. Actually, for 2001, disconnect this call, guys. Disconnect this call. For this 2001, what I have done, just see the configuration. Let's see it here. What I have done, do show run section ephone-dn. See here, for this DN number 1, I have assigned the 2001. I said that you should be dual line. Dual line means two lines I have assigned for this, which means two channels I have assigned for this single extension, which means, for example, let's go and see this example. So from 2002, I am calling to 2001. Then answer this call. So I can able to talk now. Just to avoid this, I am going to put in the mute, and I am going to put in the mute here. Now what I am doing now, from 2003 to, I am calling to 2001. Let's go and do that. See, automatically second call it came. And I can able to see that somebody is calling. Because why? Because this DN, it contains two channels, which means the first channel is already occupied with Malaysia. Whenever somebody is called, then the second call, it came here. For example, I am attending this call now. Let's see, answer this call. Now I am going to mute. Let's see here. I am going to put mute. And I can able to see both calls here. So now, by default, Malaysia went to the hold. And if you see here, it's showing the hold. And if you want to attend that call, you can resume that call. You can talk to this person sometime. Then after that, again, come back to this guy. So if you want to make a hold, make a hold. And go to this and again resume. And I can talk to Jahangir now. So why? Because the future is this. Because we have given two channels. If you see here, I said that DN number one, it has a two channels. Dual line means two lines. Now what I will do to understand, I am going to take one more phone and I want to call 2001, but the call will not come. See here, 2001. See, the guy, whenever he is trying to call Seshu, he is able to see the busy tone. Why? The problem is, for 2001, we allocated only two lines. So at a time, he can able to receive two calls. That's the reason we made it dual line. Is it clear, guys? Do you understand this concept? And again, if you want to make a call, you cannot do that. For example, see here, whenever I click new call, I am not able to do new call. Is it clear? Why? Because the two channels are occupied. What I am trying to tell you, for every call, it's required a channel. Without that, you cannot make any calls. Right now, these two channels are busy. Why? Because the channel 1 is connected with Mahesh, channel 2 is connected with Jahangir. So I don't have any other channels. So far, is it clear, guys? So now I can make it end this call. So Jahangir is end. So now when I click new, then immediately see here, the channel is free for me. That's why I got the dial tone. Then I can make a call to other party. Let's go and do the call to 2003. See, the Jahangir phone is ringing. Now I am talking to Jahangir. Let's go and talk now. Yeah, now this call is attended. See, right now my two channels are busy now. So I am going to disconnect this call and I am going to disconnect this call. So this is the purpose. What exactly the channels? Hope you guys are clear on this part. Are you clear? Do you understand? So what is happening here? Before you are going to assign any extension, you need to start with ephone DN and you need to give any one number. The number is saying that what is the number of the DN. Then after that, you need to start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 like that. Then after that, whenever you say dual line, which means you are going to allocate two channels for single extension. Then after that, you need to tell what's your extension number and what name you want and what label you want. You can able to specify this. And same way what I have done, I just want to create for you one more thing, guys. ephone-dn, let's say this time I'm going to give 20. Then after that, I said that you can give question mark here. You can able to create dual line or octo line, which means at a time one extension can contain 8 lines, so that 8 people at a time they can make a calls. So that's what I'm trying to show you. Now what I'm going to do now, for example, for you, I'm going to show you octo line. The moment when you hit enter, okay, it's saying that maximum DNs are 20. Maximum what I've done, DN 20 exceeds maximum DN 10. Why? Because while I'm going to configure the telephony services, just go here, section telephony-service. You can able to see that what is the maximum DNs I told? 10. But here what I'm trying to do, I'm going to create 20. So this is wrong. Are you clear, guys? So you can give the number from 1 to 10 only. You cannot give more than that. That's why it's saying that. Because if you see here, don't do this way. Do show run section ephone-dn. If you see here, DN1 is created, DN2 is created, DN3 is created, DN4 is created. After that, I created DN10. But so far, people, they think, okay, I created just only 5 DNs, but still I can able to create another 5 DNs. But the thing is that here the meaning is the DN numbers, maximum DN is 1 to 10 only. Which means if you want to create a DN, either you can use 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 or 9 or 10. This is the meaning of that. Hope you guys are clear on this. So now what I'm going to do, let's go and do that. Ephone DN 9 dual line. Let's say I want to create octo line. See, it's created total 8 lines. Did you see here? Because before when I try to create the DN with 20, it's not accepted. Are you clear? Now you can say that I just want to give you, let's say that number, I want to give 2009. Then after that name Akbar. Then after that label Akbar. So that this is the name and label we are going to specify. If Akbar trying to call anybody, it will show to another phone calling from Akbar. If Akbar wants to receive any call calling to Akbar, you can able to see like that. So that's why we need to specify this. Hope you guys are clear on this concept. So now you can able to see that totally how many DNs I created. Show run section ephone-dn. So that you can able to see how many DNs I created so far. So far I have created up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 9 and 10. I have created the DNs up to the 6 DNs I have created. I can able to create more 4 DNs. But make sure that the DN numbers will start from 1 to 10. So this is the way how you are going to create. But now again, I just want to show you one more interesting stuff. For example, if you see here, button number 1, I mean line number 1, which is associated with the DN1. This is what we saw here. If you see here, right now this is my DN number 1. So this DN number 1, what I have done, which is assigned to my line number 1. And again, the remaining lines are free. But what is my plan? I just want to assign, let's say that, I just want to assign. So if you see here, so what I have done in our CIPC, ephone DN1, is assigned to my ephone line 1, which means my button 1. So for button 1, I have assigned the DN1. So how you are doing this, you are going to say ephone 1. Then after that, there is a command button. So button in the sense, if you see here, this is button number 1, button number 2, button number 3, button number 4, button number 5, button number 6, button number 7, button number 8. So totally in this phone, there is 8 buttons are there. Already the first button, what I have done, I said that button 1, I said that DN 1, 1 colon 1, which means already I created the DN 1,
DN1 for 2001. So I assigned the button 1 2001. So that's why you can able to see the name session. Now what I want to do, I want to assign this DN to button number 2. So what I want to do, I need to type button 2, which means this button, I want to give DN9. So the DN9 will come there. So that DN9 is belongs to Akbar, so that I can able to add Akbar and I can able to add, so which means the same phone, it contains two lines. That's what my meaning is. Okay, so now what you can do now, just go and do that. So just see here, I'm going to say, first of all, you need to see what configurations I made it on that. Conft do show run section ephone 2. I have given two spaces, guys, ephone number 1. See here, so that is my CIPC. So that's why if you see here, the configuration is saying that it's a CIPC phone and button 1 colon 1. Means button 1, we assign the DN1. Now what I want to do, I want to assign button 2 DN9. So what you are going to do, just go to that phone. See guys, just go to that phone. Type ephone space 1. Then you can say button 2 colon 9. Then after that, see here, there is no changes here. So button 2, it should come the DN number 9. DN9 means this is for Akbar. It should come there. So, but it's not come yet. What I told you, whatever changes you made it, make sure that you need to say restart. So press restart. Then automatically, if you see here, the phone is going to restarting now. Then immediately, zoop, it's going to come. See here? There you go. So now, if you see here, the same phone, it contains two lines. The first one is 2001 and second one is Akbar, which is 2009. So which means if somebody trying to call 2009, see here the phone will ring. See, Malesh is calling to Akbar. Are you clear, guys? So right now, see here, this button is indicating with yellow, which means this line is busy now. Is it clear? Are you clear? So you can answer this call. That's it. Okay. And again, just hold this guy. Okay. Now I just want to make a call to 2001. Just make a call 2001. See, now I made a call to 2001. See, the first button is ringing and it's saying that the second button in the green means already he is in the call. And see that right now this button is blinking. So now I can click on that. I can attend the call. That's it. And same time, you know that again for this button, we already allocated two channels. For this line, we allocated 8 channels. So that at a time, 8 people, they can make a call. Are you clear, guys? Do you understand this concept? Now again, let's say I want to make a new call. So if you want to make a new call, you can select which line you want. Okay. So that is the benefit of your Cisco IP ports. Hope you guys are clear on this concept. Are you clear, guys? Yeah. So I just want to resume and I want to end this call so that I can able to do that. And same time, if you want, you can do one more thing, guys. For example, someone told you that even in the Malaysia phone, he want to see the Akbar line. So you want to add the Akbar extension. Here, this is called shared line. The concept, we can call it as a shared line. So here, the shared line is nothing but the same extension is assigned to the two IP phones. Let's say that this is IP phone number 1 and this is IP phone number 2. Let's say that line 1, what I have done, I have given 2001 and line 2 means button 2, I have given 2009. And again, if you see this is your Malaysia phone, the line 1, which means button 1, it has assigned to 2002 and he also wants 2009. So that what you can do, the same extension, same line, you can give it to the multiple extension. Multiple phones, that is called shared line. So you are going to use a single line to multiple people. So that is called shared line. So the same extension, we are going to use it in multiple phones. So we can call it as a shared line. So how to do that? Simply what you can do, just go to Malaysia phone. Malaysia phone is ephone 2, I believe. Just go and check the configuration. Do show ephone, show run. You need to say section ephone, then give two spaces, then 2. Yes, that's correct. See here, button 1, we put DN2. DN2 is belongs to Malaysia, which is 2002. Now you need to go to ephone 2. Then you need to type a command. Let's say that button 2:9. Then after that restart, then see here the Malaysia phone is going to restarting now. Yes, I can able to see, guys. Yes, the phone is restarted. Perfect. Now here I can able to see two extensions on the same phone. The first one is Malaysia and second one is Akbar. If you want to see that, do show run section ePhone 2. Then you can able to see here what it's saying. For the button 1, we configure DN2. For button 2, we configure DN3. So button 1 DN2 means button 1, we said that the extension is 2002. Then button 2, the extension is 2009. That is the meaning of that, guys. Hope you are clear now. But here the advantage is that if anybody calls 2009, which phone is going to ring? Why? The reason behind this, 2009 is configured in Seshu phone as well as Malaysia phone. So let's do that. See here. So now what I'm doing, I'm trying to call 2009. See, both phones are ringing at a time because it's a shared line. But here, whoever attend the call first, for example, I'm attending from my physical phone. See, automatically it's showing here the red color. Did you able to see, guys? Are you able to see here? It's showing the red color, which means the same line is assigned to, so same extension is assigned to the two phones, and right now that extension is busy, which means that extension is already somebody is using. That's why I can able to see the red indicator. Are you able to clear? Do you understand? So here the thing is that it's a shared line, which means the same extension has given to the two phones. Whenever somebody called to that extension, the two phones are going to ring. Then who attended the first? Then the first phone is going to connect with that, and the second phone will show you in red indicator, which means the line is used. The line is using by somebody else. It's busy now. Is it clear? And now I want to show you one more thing. If somebody try again 2009, see, the call is coming there. Why? What would be the reason? Because we already created, see here, now you can able to call. Are you able to understand, guys? Because we have created before. Now here on my phone, I can able to see the red indicator. Because the thing is that we already configured. Did you remember? We already configured 8 channels. That's why people can able to make a call to that extension. So hope you guys are clear on the shared line concept. Is it clear, guys? Do you understand the concept of shared line? Okay. Now let's go and see other stuff. For example, let's say that I just want to delete this extension. I don't want that. Why? Because it's going to use the multiple channels, and I don't want to waste the channels, because since I have created 8 channels, which means it's going to consume my DSP resources. So that's why what I want to do, I want to delete this. How to do that? So first of all, let's say that, okay, usually what we will do, we just go there, ePhone number 2, and I just want to say no, because I just want to understand everybody, guys. Button 2:9. Then after that, make sure that you need to say restart, right? So whatever changes you made it, you need to say restart. And right now I am in ePhone number 1. This is ePhone 1, guys. Still it's here because I deleted from ePhone 2 only. So now I need to delete this one. How to do that? Go to ePhone 1. Then after that, you can say no, button 2:9. Then after that, restart. Now what will happen? Automatically it's going to restart your phone, and it's going to delete that whatever you configured there. So it's going to updating now. It will take bit second and it's going to come back now. See here, again Seshu is back. Akbar is removed there. And again, what I want to do, I just want to delete permanently that DN9. So how to delete that? You can say that no, because these are the useful commands, guys. You can say no ePhone-DN, then you can say 9. Did you remember that? Which DN you want to delete? Just you can go do show run section ePhone-DN 9. So you can see here this DN I want to delete it. The reason behind this, I have created octoline, 8 lines I have created, guys, because it's going to consume 8 channels. So I don't want to do that. So what you can do, you can say simply no ePhone-DN, then you can say 9. So now see here, everything is deleted. So the resources is going to coming back again. You no need to worry about. So that's why you type do show voice port summary. You cannot able to see those. See here, what I told you guys, whenever you created any channels,
automatically when you type show voice port summary, it's going to create virtual channels. See here, for example, if you see DN10, it has two channels. That's why I can able to see two, one and two. And again, if you see DN number 4, it has two channels. If you see here DN number 3, it has two channels. For example, for your testing, I am going to create E4-DN5. I don't want to create any channels. When I hit enter, by default, it's going to create one channel. See here, then it will show you one pop-up message. Did you see here? One channel has created. Now what you can do, I can give number 2005, name Akbar again, and label Akbar. Now you can see here, do show voice port summary. Then you can see here 5005 is created with one channel. There is no other channel. Did you see here? So by default, whenever you create the DNs, based on how many lines you are allocating, based on that many channels will create, that many virtual ports will create. Is it clear, guys? Do you understand this? And I want to show you one more thing here. Be yourself very passionate now. You will feel something surprise. So now do show voice port summary. I told you that this 5001, if you see here, this is for DN number 1. 5002, this is for DN number 2, because I created two channels. That's why it's showing 1 and 2 with the same number. And again, if you see here, did you see here? And if you see here 5003, it is showing again two channels. Now what I am going to do, if you see here, I just click on this phone and I press the speaker phone. So I am getting the dial tone. So I can able to dial the numbers. And here you can type the same command. Now you will find something change. See here, it's showing that off hook. What is this? For example, I am going to other phone. Okay, let's close this call again. I'm sorry for that. Okay, then I closed again, open the type the same command again. It's saying that on hook. What is off hook? What is on hook? Because off hook is nothing but you have a cradle. So the cradle, whenever it's hanging on the phone, which means that is called on hook. If you want to make a call, what you will do, you will take the cradle, then this is called off hook, and you are going to put it on nearby your ear. Then that time you will see here, do show voice port summary. Now this is DN number 2, that's why this see here, it went to the off hook. Again, when I put it back, it's on hook, because I just hooked the phone. Again, if you go back and type the command, you can able to see here on hook. Is it clear? Now, and also here, I just want to show you, because we are learning little the voice concepts. So make sure that, for example, I dial it again, 2002. So now the phone is ringing, and just see here you are able to see the complete status. Right now 5001 off hook, and again see here it's a ringing, and attend the call. So put mute, and here also put mute. Let's open this phone. Okay, now see the status, do show voice port summary. Now see here, both phones are on off. It's showing the clear information, guys. Are you clear? Do you understand this? And also, I want to show you one more thing. Do show voice call summary. This is the fantastic, guys. Don't ask me what is this. Actually, this command is going to show you right now which channel is using and which codec is using. So see here, between these two phones, in DN number 1, 1.1 means the first channel is using at the moment, and it's in the connecting state. And here it's using G.711 EULA, guys. Okay, G711 EULA. So this is the codec which is using, if you see here. And again, if you see here, there is one more codec which is using there. So again, if I close this, then you can able to see, do show voice call summary, then you can able to see the normal thing. So this is what I'm trying to tell you guys, exactly how it's going to work. This is the basic, very basic stuff, but it will give you very energy. That's what I am trying to tell you guys. Whenever you are going to configure this DNs and all, make sure that you must clear on this concept. So hope you are clear, guys. So what I am going to do in the next video, I am going to show you how to configure other features, so that for every feature I am going to make one video, so it's easy for you. You're not going to get any bore. That's what my main intention, guys. Thank you for watching this video.